This conference will now be recorded.
Hi and hello everyone. Welcome to Isha Training Solutions. Today we are going to see performance engineering demo. Hope my voice is audible for everyone. My screen is also visible for everyone. So before going into the demo, myself, Saravanan. So I have close to 13 years of experience in this field. I know various performance engineering tools, performance testing tools, utility tools, APM level tools. So I have quite a bit of experience in this, this sector. And then I work with multiple customers, multiple verticals, multiple technologies. So what we are going to do here in this training journey is that, like, we wanted to get that understanding. I mean, what is performance engineering means? What are all the activities that we are doing it in performance engineering? What is actually expected? Okay, who are all actually qualified or eligible to do this kind of an activity? So like that, the entire activity what we are going to do, we are going to learn performance engineering in detail. In detail, we are going to learn the performance engineering. Okay, so I'll explain maybe the course content that we are going to cover as part of this course journey, and then we will maybe discuss. Okay, I encourage you guys, please stop me at any point of time. If you guys wanted to ask any question to me, please stop me at any point of time, ask your questions. Because say here, why we are giving this demo is very simple, that you are going to assess or evaluate us what is actually expected from your side and whether we are fulfilling that requirement or not. That is what the real expectation out of this demo session. So you guys can stop me at any point of time, ask your questions. What is your expectation and what is actually available here? Is it actually matching your requirement? Then we will be proceeding with this session. Okay, so please stop me at any point of time if you really feel like you need any clarifications to be explained. Okay, explained. So and you can even mention, like, even sometimes you can mention your requirements as well. So based on that, we can discuss it. Okay. So the main thought process behind this course content creation is that, like, we wanted to bring in the awareness across the layer. Okay, across the layer, how will you do the performance engineering activity? Okay, so we all know it's like an ocean. Okay, it's like an ocean. We wanted to bring that attention or the awareness, like, say, like, you wanted to do something on the application level, what you have to do. If you want to do something on the front end level, what you have to do. If you wanted to do something on the database level, what you have to do. You wanted to do something on the infrastructure level, what you have to do, like that. This entire course content is actually designed in such a way that you are going to have awareness across the layer. I mean, understanding across the layer. Okay, that is how this entire course content is actually prepared. And all these course content, what we are planning to do is that, like, we wanted to go with a practical understanding instead of a theoretical understanding. So we wanted to bring in that flavor that, say, like, I am going to provide a sample application to you all. All of you will be getting that sample application. And I will tell you how to deploy that sample application into your local machine. Okay. I mean, the procedures, okay, the procedure in which you are going to do the application launching in your local machine. So that application is actually a Java based application deployed on Apache Tomcat server. So that explanation only I mentioned. So you guys will be getting that understanding how this Java application is going to be deployed on top of the Apache Tomcat server. The procedure, step A, step 2, step 3, step 4, like that, I will explain. And then you are going to typically follow the same instruction, and then you are going to deploy that application into your local machine. Okay. So what will happen, whatever the topic that we are covering, say, like, heap dump topic or thread dump topic or garbage collection topic, whatever the topic that we are covering, you also have the provision to do that in your local machine. I mean, because the application is there in your local machine. So you are going to do that heap dump, thread dump, garbage collection, all those understanding, you are going to do it in your local machine itself. So what we are trying to bring in this course journey, the practical experience, how to do the heap dump, how to do the thread dump, how to do the garbage analysis, what are all the different options are available in analyzing the heap dump, what are all the different options available in thread dump analysis, like that. We are going to have a multiple ways in which you are going to do this analysis, and different tools we are going to learn. Okay, different tools we are going to learn. Say, like, what is JVisual VM, or what is JConsole, or what is JStack, or what is JCommand. Okay, like that, there are utility tools we are going to learn. Right? Even we will be learning, like, GC, how will you analyze it? Or heap, how will you analyze it? Thread, how will you analyze it? Say, like, there is a tool called Heap Hero, or there is a tool called fastthread.io, fastthread.io, and there is a tool called GCEC. Like that, each and everything, there are certain tools that are available in the market. How we are going to use the tool for your investigation, that level also we are going to learn. So I would say close to 10 to 15 different tools and utilities we are going to learn it, and we are going to get the benefits. So the primary thing what we have to understand, practically we are going to do all these things, so that it is an experience that we are gaining. Okay, even those who are completing our performance engineering session, and those who are going for any interviews, after clearing the interview, what they are telling it to us is that whenever they are talking about these heap dump, thread dump, garbage collection concepts and all in the interview, the chances are very high to clear the interview. That is how they are saying. Even everybody, whenever they are giving the feedback, they are telling in that way only. So that shows that what is the expectation in the market now. Okay, what is the expectation in the market? The expectation is very simple. You are going to get this knowledge, implement it in your real world, and then make your job in a streamlined way. Okay, your application will be working with a performance optimized way. Okay, that is how performance engineering is actually comes into the picture. Okay, so what I'm going to do, say, I'll take a pause here. Anybody have any question? You can ask your question, please. Okay, so we'll quickly go into the course content detail, because there, if you guys feel like anything expected from you, you can tell. Okay, so the first understanding is performance engineering introduction. I mean, what you are going to do, what is performance engineering, and then each and every activity that you are doing, right? There is a life cycle involved in that. So, say when developer is doing certain activity, SDLC, software development life cycle. When functional tester is actually doing certain activity, STLC, software testing life cycle. Okay, if performance testers are doing anything, PTLC, performance testing life cycle. So if performance engineers are doing any activity, PELC, performance engineering life cycle. So which means that each and everybody, whenever they are doing certain activity, there is a life cycle activity. Okay, so we are going to discuss what are all the activities that are performed by, the performance engineers. Okay, life cycle activity, and then individual activity, what are all the things performed by performance engineers. Okay. So in the introduction part, what we are going to set the context is that, like, what is performance engineering first? Okay, and life cycle, and then activities performed by the performance engineers, because that you should know, right? Like, because say I told you it's an ocean, So which means that you have a proper understanding where and all performance engineer's contribution is there and what you have to start with. Okay, you mean whether you are going to start with what understanding and then how we are going to proceed. That also we are going to get that understanding, because that is how your journey is actually starting. Okay, journey is starting by starting each and every layer level understanding. Okay, each and every layer level understanding, because in industry that is the expectation. Anybody from performance testing background here, guys? Anybody from performance testing?
Yeah, I'm from performance testing back.
Yeah, wonderful. Okay, so,
yeah, even I'm, this is Dilip here, so I'm from performance testing.
Yeah, Dilip. Good to know, Dilip. So, guys, like, maybe I don't know how many years of experience you guys are. So, you think like this. You completed your 8th year or you completed your 10th year in performance testing. Example, okay, I'm just saying, okay, 8th year or 10th year in performance testing you guys completed, what your boss will ask you, your manager, what they will ask you, or what is that they will expect from you?
Yeah,
what is that they will expect from you? If you completed your 8th year and then 10th year, you are completed in your journey as a performance tester, you completed your 8th year or 10th year, you completed your journey like that, what your manager will be expected, or your super boss, your customer will be expecting from you? Anybody experienced it before? You can share your experience. What they will expect from you?
Yeah, the main purpose is like they'll be looking for who can be a performance tester, who can be as a performance engineering as well. So the focus is like to more like need to identify the root cause and where exactly, or all those areas. So towards me, yeah, on the performance engineering, so as well as to understand the JVM, how it works, and then all those things, like for Java perspective as well, tuning. So that was the focus.
Wonderful. Yeah. Wonderful, Dilip. Wonderful. Yeah, very well articulated. So maybe he's actually faced the problem. That's the reason he's able to articulate it. So the thing is that, no, when you are going up in the ladder, I mean your career ladder, when you are going up in the ladder, what will happen over the journey? Even everybody will expect. I'll share my experience. My manager directly told me, "Do you think after completing your 8th year also you will say still you will do testing alone? Why not more than that?" That is how he asked me like that. Do you say like still I will do only scripting, only execution, that's all, and only reporting, at that too whatever the report provided by performance testing tool, that is the only report I will share like that. Do you think like that is enough? That is how my manager asked. And the expectation is that, like, over the period you need to transition yourself from performance tester to performance engineer. That is the expectation. Okay, I mean, how far you are going to fulfill that requirement and all, different story, guys, because nobody in the world is the perfect in this case. Okay, but at least you start your transition from performance tester to performance engineer, where and all you can contribute your knowledge. Okay, I mean, which layer, infrastructure monitoring or something on database or something on application or something on UI layer, where you can contribute, still you can do it, but that transition, it is actually expected. So even there are customers, you know, they will straight away ask this question, say your experience level is 10 years and you are still saying I will do a web application recording replay and then execution report. What customer told me is that, like, say you are 10 year experienced guy, I need to spend max of 10 lakhs to 12 lakhs per annum for the activity that you are doing. I'm providing 10 lakhs to 12 lakhs. The similar activity, even a 3 year experience to four year experience to performance tester can do. Why should I pay this much of a money doing the same work done by the 3 year or 4 year performance tester? No, this is not expected. Can you do little more, little more, little beyond whatever the activity that you are doing. That is what every customer or even every manager, they start, they'll ask this kind of a question only when you become little experienced performance tester. I don't know how many of you already experienced it, but that will be the expectation. That will be the expectation that over the journey, you should be good in performance engineering aspect as well, not only performance testing. Because yes, your core job is performance testing only, but performance engineering aspect also expected over the period of time. And I don't know how many of you are working in product based companies, like the two product based companies, the top MNC companies, how many of you are working, I don't know. But in there are organizations, the job role itself performance engineers only. Actually, performance testing only they will do. Performance testing only they will do. But the job role is actually performance engineers, because it is expected that you need to do additional things. You need to do additional things. In there are product companies, you know, they'll call that as DevOps engineers or digital engineers or the performance engineers, because the expectation is you should do more from performance testing activity, not only performance testing activity. So there are organizations, they are still expecting these kind of things. So why I'm saying all these things, because the industry is transitioning from the unified activity to multitasking activity. I mean, you cannot say like I'll only do performance testing. No, I know this alone, like that and all, you cannot say, because the industry is moving to agile DevOps mode, right? So you should be a multitasking guy, and you should know other skill sets as well. That is the expectation now. So that is making us to come to this layer. I mean, performance, why we have to learn performance engineering? That question, if we are getting it, you know, the answer is this one only. The need is actually changed now. You need to make yourself a little more advanced. You cannot still say like, I know LoadRunner, I know JMeter. Yes, that is a primary skill. I know LoadRunner, I know JMeter is actually a primary skill, but there are value add things that we need to learn, so that you're over the journey, when you become experienced, this will actually help you to do your activities. Okay, I'll take a pass here. Anybody have any question till now? You can ask your question, please.
Yeah, I have a question. So what are your thoughts on site reliability engineer? How does it differ from a performance engineering role?
It is also quite closer to the activities that we are doing. It is that's what I'm saying. The terms and terminologies only, Mark. How shall I call you? Is it Mohsin? Mohsin, right?
Yeah,
Mohsin. So it is actually the because of the technology change or the trend change, people are changing the names only. Okay, but internally, if you everybody is actually cross-sharing these similar activities only. That the latest trend is actually site reliability. Okay, so even DevOps engineers also nowadays the very famous things. And similarly, you have your digital engineers. Okay, that is also nowadays very famous.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so but in the site reliability engineering, yes, it is also a software engineering concept only, but more towards the infrastructure and operational problems they will deal with. Okay, they'll deal with infrastructure and operation problems. But if you think about the performance engineers, their role is not confined to particular activity. Across the layer, they can do anything. I mean, UI layer, application layer, database layer, infrastructure layer, like that, across the layer, they can focus on. Okay, clear?
Yeah, thank you.
Sure. So just now I mentioned like this, over the period you become experienced, the expectation is actually coming from the team that you need to do additional things, right? So even that is not from the performance testers alone. I'll tell you, even the developers are also the same case. Developers also the same case. Early part of your career, say like started your career as a fresher developer, early time if you are doing any mistake, I mean when you are doing any little code level mistake or a certain looping level mistake or certain resource utilization level mistake like that, if you are doing, at least people will accept. I mean early part of your career they will accept. But over the journey, the same 8 years or 10 years or 12 years of your experience, what people will expect from you is that like your code should be a performance optimized code. Your code should be a performance optimized code. You are getting my point, right? Like you cannot compromise with the performance when you become experienced. When you become experienced, you cannot compromise with your performance. Because say like in your early part of your career, say like you are writing a chunk of code. In your early part of your career, when you are writing a chunk of code, say maybe you are using unnecessary looping conditions, unnecessary declaration of the objects like that, if you are doing also, people will not take it that seriously. But when you become little experienced fellow, like 8 year, 10 year, 12 year experienced developer, you know, small mistake if you are doing, very small mistake that if you are doing also, people will ask you 100 questions like why you cannot avoid this or what, these or what, that or what, like that. That time they will also expect, say like when you are writing a Java, in Java whether you are writing an optimized code or what, or whether you are following the best practice or what, your code is actually going to use less utilization or resource utilization or what, like that only the expectations would be. So in that case also, the performance engineering is actually a mandatory, because then only, say if you know the concepts only, you will do the things properly. Okay, so that is the expectation, that is the expectation. So what we are trying to do, it is not for performance engineers alone, even the developers also the same problem. Even developers also, over the journey, it is expected that they have to do plus one apart from the regular activity that you are doing. So that is where the importance of performance engineering is actually comes into the picture. Okay, any question, guys?
Performance engineering should be
in this.
Please, one at a time.
Yeah, you go ahead.
Yeah, okay. So will you be covering any, so all the course syllabus that you have, right, will there be any topics which would give us information about network monitoring and infrastructure monitoring?
Network as such, network monitoring we are not doing, but infrastructure monitoring we are doing. Okay, infrastructure monitoring we are doing. In that I am going to explain Windows level monitoring and Linux level monitoring. I'm going to explain. Okay, in that Linux monitoring explanation, there is a command called netstats. Netstat. Okay, I don't know whether you guys are already worked in Linux, Unix, Linux systems. There you have a commands like vmstat, netstat, iostat, sir, top, nmon. All these are actually the famous commands. Okay, so in that netstats is there, which is actually going to provide you the network level statistics. So that is actually covered, Mohsin.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, sure.
Performance engineering can be done on live servers, or how it is?
Yes, you can do. See, it is not about live, it is not about QA or prod. Okay, where you have the full control over it, you can do it. Okay, you can do it. And but I would say practical things. Practical things in the sense like even you can do it in the live environment of the QA, because your real data is not going to disturb, so end users will be a little happy. But once you have the admin privilege, I mean data gathering, data logging analysis, or you have your APM tool analysis like that, when you have the live data available, if you are able to identify, say like your UI components are taking so and so time, your DB queries are taking so and so time, are your infrastructure utilization, CPU utilization, memory utilization, which is actually taking more time like that. When you are able to get it, that's where your involvement is actually started. And when you are started providing recommendations, that's all. You are considered to be a good resource. I mean, because you are providing the expectation. What is actually expected? Don't give a blunt number. Don't give a blunt number. Say like in this performance testing, I mean, in this group itself, there are performance testers are there. Let's say like a search transaction is actually taking 10 seconds. A search transaction is actually taking 10 seconds. Okay. I'm giving that number to my developer saying like search transaction is actually 10 seconds. What is the reaction, guys, from the developers? If you are saying like search transaction is actually taking 10 seconds, what is the reaction? What is the usual reaction from developers?
They'll be asking where exactly, whether it belongs to any queries or like where exactly it happens, which layer or which object, all those things.
Wonderful. Yeah, Dilip, correct. So yes, guys, what he is saying is correct, right? So the developers will get, sometimes they'll even talk with you even in angry mode also. Even I experienced it multiple times whenever we are giving this kind of a blunt high level numbers, you know, like 10 seconds it is taking, means they'll ask where it is. Is it on the app layer? Is it on the DB layer? Is it on the infrastructure level? Where it is? Say if you are simply coming and telling me that search transaction is actually taking 10 seconds, that I can do myself, right? Like developer will ask like this, I can do by myself, right? Like even I have the stopwatch with me, I will load the page and then I will check it, like how much of a second it is actually taking, like that also I can provide the number. You took more than 20 days or more than 15 days to tell that search transaction is actually taking 10 seconds. You did the scripting, you did the execution, and finally you are saying search transaction is actually taking 10 seconds. Means that I can tell it in the first day itself using the stopwatch itself. What is the value that you are adding after doing the performance testing? That is how the developer will ask the performance system. Because for them, if you are giving the high level number as search transaction is actually 10 seconds, they'll get irritated only because you need to give little more clarity for the time that is actually taking. Any URL that is actually taking or what? Or any particular time in which it is actually happening or what? Or you are getting like, is it on the DB, is it on the application, is it on the UI, where it is actually taking time, like that. If you are giving little more additional information, there comes the involved. Okay, everybody able to understand what I'm saying? Okay, so that's where your engineering or your understanding is actually important, because if you are giving a very high level numbers, the developer sometimes will get irritated and say, hey, what is this? You are giving only high level number. How do I come to know where it is actually taking, what it is actually taking and all? Give me details, man. Like that only they will ask you. Okay, so these are the reasons because of which we are going to learn this performance engineering course. Okay, performance engineering course, this is the reason. And one more thing also, I don't know in this forum how many are preparing for interviews or trying to switch the job and all, I don't know, but I'm saying whichever the job description nowadays, if you go and see, definitely these concepts are available nowadays. I mean the performance engineering concepts, or even at least one APM tool will be there in the list. One APM tool will be there in the list, and then these concepts are there. Even the heap dump, thread dump, garbage collection concepts are there in the job description. So what is that meaning? It is not only performance testing nowadays. Going forward, you need to have a performance engineering knowledge as well. That is the meaning. That is the meaning, because in the job description, they are asking performance engineering topics, means because the expectation is that. The expectation is that you should be talking about those things as well. Okay. So moving on to the next thing, we are going to have a Java performance engineering concepts as well. Okay, I mean Java level, we are going to get the core understanding of engineering concepts. So in that activity, we are going to learn about JVM architecture, Java Virtual Machine architecture. Okay, we will be understanding in detail what is actually the architecture, what are all the individual components that are there, individual component, what functionality it is actually performing, like that. We are going to see the JVM architecture, JVM architecture, and then JVM performance monitoring. What is JVM performance monitoring? So where your Java program is actually running, your Java program is running on top of the JVM, and how will you do the monitoring with respect to memory, with respect to thread, with respect to garbage collection, how will you do the monitoring? In that, there are two utility tools we are going to learn. One is JConsole and then JVisualVM. Both the tools are inside your JDK file itself, inside the JDK, inside the bin folder itself. These two utility tools are there. So we are going to learn how heap analysis can be done, how thread analysis can be done, how you are going to simulate this reactions. Okay, say like you are going to use our sample application and you are going to simulate the load when you are giving so and so load in the system, how your threads are behaving, how your memory is behaving. Okay, if you are keep on increasing the load, what is actually happening after a certain point of time, what is actually happening, like that. You can do your understanding using these two utility tools. Okay, and then there is a commercial tool called YourKit, which is a profiling tool. Okay, YourKit Java Profiler, the full name is YourKit Java Profiler. In industry, they will call familiarly as YJP. YJP, YourKit Java Profiler, YJP, like that they will call that as. And that tool we are going to learn it for the JVM monitoring itself, how your JVM monitoring will be done using the YJP tools. That learning also we are going to have it, and then we are going to completely learn that tool. I mean, each and every tab level, capability level, feature level we are going to discuss. And then JVM heap structure. Okay, I mean, when you are doing a garbage collection, okay, say like in Java, when you are doing a garbage collection, I mean minor garbage collection, major garbage collection, full garbage collection, when you are trying to do, how the functionality is actually happened, how the objects that are loading in hidden space, how that is actually moving to survivor space, how it is actually moving to tenured space, like that, we are going to have a detailed understanding. That is also we are going to learn. And then when you are configuring this heap, okay, say like XMS and then XMMax value. Okay, so those are working in JMeter, who already would have aware of these concepts. Apache JMeter, those who are working already would have heard this before. Those are working in JMeter, anybody working in JMeter? So I think nobody is working in JMeter. So in JMeter, there is a settings available. Okay, I don't know how many of them checked it before. Say like I'll go here. This is Apache JMeter. Inside the Apache JMeter bin folder, there is a file name called JMeter.batch file. Okay, if I open that, how JMeter is actually working? They are having a heap size setting of 1 GB. They are having the heap size setting of 1 GB, min size and max size setting they are having. Okay, so in our course journey, I'm going to explain these aspects also. Your JMeter is actually using G1GC. Okay, your JMeter is actually using G1GC, garbage first, garbage collection. So like this, we are going to have a real world example, and then we are going to learn these terms and terminologies and then functionalities as well. So that also we will be covering it. And then different garbage collectors, I mean serial GC, parallel GC, concurrent mark and sweep and then G1GC. Those are all the different types of garbage collectors that we are going to see with example. And then JVM thread pooling concepts. Okay, thread pooling concepts. What is core pool size? What is bounded queue, unbounded queue? That understanding also we are going to have it. And then JDBC connection pooling with respect to database. With respect to database, JDBC connection pooling, we are going to understand it. And then detailed way in which we are going to analyze the JVM thread dumps. Okay, thread dumps. JVM thread dumps. In that learning, we are going to have the thread lifecycle as well. I'm going to explain like thread lifecycle and then various tools that are available, how to capture the thread dump, how to analyze it. Similarly, what is heap dump means, and then various heap dump tools, and then how to capture the heap dumps and then analyze it. Okay. Similarly, garbage collection. Garbage collection, how to capture the garbage collection logs, and then how to analyze your garbage collection, and then different techniques. That also we are going to learn. And then we are going to have an understanding of what is out of memory, what is memory leak, like that also we are going to see. Okay, this is all the above topics are Java related things. We are going to go with a deep dive analysis, okay, with respect to heat dump analysis, thread dump analysis, garbage analysis, and different tools to capture these logs, different analysis technique like that. We are going to go with a detailed understanding of this Java based stuff. And then infrastructure monitoring. There is actually saying many performance testers in the industry right now, they are not doing the infrastructure monitoring. Say those who are coming for interview with me, okay, if I ask them, say like if they are 4 years to 7 years experienced candidate, if I ask, do you know infrastructure monitoring like that, many are saying no only. What they are saying, either they are saying I don't have access, there is a separate team available for doing the infrastructure monitoring like that, but we are going to learn detailed way of infrastructure monitoring, because that is actually mandatory thing. Okay, please try to learn the infrastructure monitoring as well. So we are going to learn different perfmont, which is a Windows level monitoring, and then different counters, that definitions and understanding. And similarly, Linux based environment, we are going to learn vmstat, netstat, iostat, top, sir, all those things we are going to learn. Similarly, there is a utility tool called nmon. How will you install the nmon into your Linux servers, and then how your data capture will be happening, that also we are going to analyze. Okay, so this is from the infrastructure monitoring perspective. Similarly, we are going to learn about database. That is also very important. See, if you go and see in the industry, say like 55% of the industry outages that are happening because of the database. So what we are trying to bring in here, that awareness about, understanding about the database monitoring as well. So we are going to learn about Oracle DB monitoring. Here we took the DB flavor as Oracle DB. So we are going to learn Oracle DB monitoring. In that, I will be explaining how to generate AWR reports, ADDM reports, and ASH reports, and then how to read and understand your AWR reports, Automatic Workload Repository Report, how we are going to understand, right, sir? So that also we are going to learn. Okay. So that database performance monitoring also we are going to learn. And then very, 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 very important topic. Every customer nowadays, they started asking this client side performance. So we are going to have how your application loaded means how will you do your investigation with respect to the browser response time, right? So we are going to learn front end performance metrics means what, how common client side problem that are happening, how your browser rendering is actually happening, what are all the different tools like Chrome dev tools, GT metrics, web page test, all those tools we are going to learn in detail. Okay, in a detailed way, we are going to learn the tool. And then code profiling. So there is a tool called JProfiler. That profiling tool also we are going to learn. And then one APM tool, which is a Dynatrace tool we are going to learn, one complete APM tool we are going to learn. Say in Isha, we are separately running this APM tool as a separate session itself. But we wanted to bring that here in the subset of your performance engineering session. So we will be learning that Dynatrace tool in a detailed way. So that is also there. And then your real-time application performance issues, say like production load analysis, or what are all the common CPU problem, memory problem, response time problem that are coming in production, right? That also we are going to discuss in detail. So, okay, in a summary, we are going to learn about Java, we are going to learn about infra, we are going to learn about DB, we are going to learn about client side, we are going to learn about profiling, we are going to learn about your APM tool. So Dynatrace API. So all flavors, all layers we covered in this course journey, which is actually a real value add if you are learning this course. I'll take a pass here. Anybody have any question? You can ask your question.
So I just have one question here. Instead of if everyone is okay with like instead of Dynatrace, if you can go for AppDynamics or something, could add a value here.
Actually, I'll tell you one thing. Till last session, it was only AppDynamics only. Last batch, day before yesterday, 3 days before one batch completed, right? In that batch, actually, AppDynamics was the topic, because many learners, they mentioned Dynatrace as a choice of tool only. We changed. Actually, I updated the content 2 days before, and then today we are having this Dynatrace as a list. Okay, so that was coming from more people that Dynatrace is actually industry familiar APM tool, and every interview we started reviewing this, so that's the reason we added this Iptika. But if you wish, you tell me, we will discuss, no problem. We'll discuss and then we'll come to the understand. Okay,
with everyone's consent and if everyone agrees to it, like those who are in this batch, then
no. See, that is not I'm saying. We'll look for alternatives, like if you are okay, even I'll share the previous batch, those session videos alone, so that you will be getting AppDynamics content, right? That is what I'm saying.
So are we going to get the content and recordings as well, right? Like this PPTs and
both,
all, whatever.
Both. Everything will be there.
Thank you.
So those who are interested to proceed with this course journey, this is Kumar's number. So I'll paste it in the chat as well. Okay, this is Kumar's number. So you can go here. This is Kumar's number, 80199-52427. So I'll repeat again. All these, see, this is actually, we are planning to have 23 plus hours of a session. Okay, 23 plus hours of a session, and each session is there for each day. We are going to take one hour of a session. Okay, and each session will be recorded, and every day we will share the recorded video in the playlist URL, YouTube playlist URL. We'll be sharing daily basis. You guys can watch it, and then if you are having any question, you can come back and then ask your questions as well. And this video, you are going to have lifetime access. You will be having a lifetime access. Okay, don't worry, you will be having a lifetime access. And then whatever the artifacts that are required, say like I told you, right, there is a sample application, there are PDF, PPTs, anything that we wanted to share, we will be sharing through a Google Drive. We will share through Google Drive. You guys can download and then you can use it for your usage. So we will share all the artifacts through the Google Drive as well. And this is actually a weekday session, Monday to Friday, weekday session, Saturday, Sunday holiday. And then this is a time slot, 8 o'clock to 9 o'clock Indian time, 8 o'clock to 9 o'clock Indian time, correspondingly in other locations. So you can make a note of it. And all these are actually weekday session. So those who really wanted to proceed with this session, please reach out to Kumar sir, which is 8019952427 is number. Any questions related to your course content or your course timing? Now Iftikhar, you are also told, right? You are expecting the change in the content. So you can talk to Kumar sir for any further information, and he will guide you what has to be done, how it can be handled like that. So please reach out to Kumar sir for any further information. So we will be starting from tomorrow. The regular topics will be started. I mean, the introduction, performance engineering introduction part, from tomorrow we are starting. So if you are enrolling for this course, so that we will have the continuity. I mean, from the first class itself, we will have a continuity because we don't want to lose any information. So those who are interested, please reach out to Kumar sir for any further information. And thanks everyone for joining this demo session. Thanks everyone for giving me this opportunity to share my knowledge and experience with you people. I'm hoping that we will all travel together in this performance engineering session, and we'll try to learn all the different things. So thanks all. Bye bye.
So just before wind up, one more question I have.
Yeah, you think I can.
All whatever topics we are doing and going through, we are going to have a hands-on, right? Like as you said, yeah, JProfiler and all these kind of tools, like profiling tools and all. We would be having a hands-on over here, or it's a kind of just a flow?
No. Hands-on only. That's what I'm saying. I'm going to show, install everything, and correspondingly, we are going to share that artifacts to you also. You set it up in your machine, and you will also do, and then you are going to bring the question, and we'll be discussing in the session. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, sure. Okay. Thanks everyone for joining today's session, and have a nice day. Bye-bye.
Thank you.